Here we go with the best team in football. Gary Lyons here. And just purple, when I think he's extricated himself out of a life-threatening illness.
Yep.
Back it comes.
He's coughing, spluttering.
Isn't he just?
And he likes us to know about it. Oh,
got his own box of tissues.
We had 2 weeks of telling you about it.
We need to know about it.
No, I've let you know for 2 weeks. I didn't say anything today, but it was obvious from looking at me. Jim picked it up earlier.
I think you need to put yourself in poor this afternoon, Gaz, the way you're going, mate.
Honestly, Gaz.
The shoulders have been carrying a fair bit around here lately, Spud. I'd just button up and start to put something out.
Spud's here. Hello to you, Spud Regis.
Great to be here. What an unbelievable game again last night.
Oh, well, I'll tell you what. And also, as I understand it, and... Well, I did mention this last night. I received a text from Spud that took up the whole of my iPhone text right from the top to the bottom, and there were words still at the top and at the bottom.
Usual spelling mistakes.
Yeah. For a head wobble, so Spud's ready to go.
Well, it's been a big week. It's fair to say I had too much time in my hands yesterday.
Oh, I tell you right now. Anyway, here we go, Spud. The head wobble. Well, it's been missing, but it's back.
There's a few nominations. There's a few flybys too, JB.
Right,
so I'm going to start up with Gaz, the number one analyst. JB, the number one caller on radio, and Dennis, the number one caller on TV.
In
the Herald Sun survey, just a little bit of a flyby there, but I must admit, I'm a bit shocked I was not in the voting, to be honest. But anyway, we'll move on.
How are we in this?
How come we're in there?
Well, it's in the Herald Sun and promo last night, promo today, so it's got to get a little flyby. The lawyers in the federal court this week making about themselves, a lot of me, and an awful lot of wobble. They were just, where's the camera? Their hair was done magnificently.
Beautifully spoken. Mark Lyon.
The chief who turned 50 on Thursday.
He's made it all about himself.
Mate, he was on Fox Footy hosting Saturday, Sundays on the couch, then interviewing himself on the couch. Thursday, Robbo's crook, so he's doing 360.
Bounce Wednesday.
Then he does
night.
Bounce Wednesday. They may as well call it Channel Chief. Now, he didn't have a party, so he had his own party. He ordered a large pizza, rolled it up like a souvlaki, and snorted it. I'm going to christen him Happy Birthday Grinch. Yeah. He's the new Grinch, the chief.
Fair enough.
Now, that brings me to Das. Now, Luke, if you're listening, mate, you're always pumping up Ruckman and how important their role is as modern-day gladiators. And Dave, as you know, is the unofficial head of the Ruckman's Association.
He is.
Guys before him like Alex Ashenko, Monkhurst, Ironmonger, Don Scott, Crackers Keane and Carl Dittrich.
Hard bastards.
Tough and uncompromising. Tough. Willing to bust through the pain barrier and withstand any challenge that comes their way.
Yes. Where's the badge of honour,
Spud? I watched the telecast of one of the games of the year. Frio v Geelong.
Yes.
Big matchups all week. Crowley versus Stevie J. Everyone's on the end of their chair.
Yep.
Hawkins versus McFarlane.
That's it.
Joel Selwood tough.
That's right. Then Channel 7 throw to Das.
No.
He has gloves on.
What?
That's right. Full leather gloves because it was a little bit chilly before the game.
Oh.
Das, the late Captain Bloodjack Doe, star of the media game for all of us, including you, big HB Pencilhead, will turn his grave. He knew Ruckman was wearing gloves in a pre-match because his pinkies might get cold. This is right up there with Wolf's bag of 10 in the 94 final. And it's out every year in the footy record of finals time. We're 3 weeks away from it again.
Does guess.
JB with North players running in the gym and strutting on the green stuff.
Bloody oath.
And having his head well and truly wedged up Gil McLaughlin's backside. And who could forget Warrior when he used the curling wand to wave one left of his wispy hair before the footy show. And Hutchie, who had the boil on his face, had his own heart and lung. I thought I was watching embarrassing bodies. I put myself in there, yours truly, who had some overdue chomper work. Das, this blatant self-promoting from you, Pinhead, has put us all on notice and even outed Jason Richardson for having the bullet out of the starter's gun who won the soul gift off at me. A marker might have 10.5 metres around his neck as a reminder when he ran the gift. Look, you skinny-headed prick. You go straight into the head wobbler hall of fame and now you're the leader in Tabs Mark. For head wobbler.
Here it is. he's back, Spud. He's back in a big way, Jim.
He's gone. Spud.
Sorry about the flyby.
I love it, but jeez, he's gone back and given a general strafing focus nicely on the jerk.
But that is right up there with Hall of Fame. Man, straight in. Hall of Fame.
Yeah, he's been sitting on some old stuff. He got it out.
Rusty.
Guys.
It's a bit like you're blue at the moment.
You got to blow the cobwebs out there, Spuddy boy.
He can't lose it. Luke. He can't lose it from me.
You're never going to get away. Well, it's going to take a lot to lose. I thought Jason Richardson was unbeatable until I watched the telecast last
just
week.
In, he's come.
And I know it's been done all week about the gloves, but it had to be put on the agenda.
It's not
here.
Done until you do it.
Exactly right.
So only you can deal with that problem.
Now Hall of Fame, and it's going to take a hell of a lot beating come grand final day.
Well, it will. But I'm still saying heads bobbing when you got the bullet out of the gun. That's still. I mean,
if it's still around his neck, I reckon he gets it's a bit like Bone Crusher, Al Waverley star. I think those two boys.
Well, Hose Mary, the beautiful Hose Mary, who does the nice steering work here on a Saturday, has to work with Duke every morning.
Yep.
And I quietly spoke to Hose the other day and just asked her if she was of the opinion, as I was, that Duke's lost his way. Hose Mary immediately said, no question.
He's a Western Suburbs ruckman.
And now he's moved into Hawthorn, gets a helicopter out to the bloody Witten Oval when they ask him to do one appearance for the year.
Yep.
And wears his gloves.
How would Scotty Wind and Gary Dempsey out there, Andrew Purser, all those... Big ruckman
big
there.
Big Cozzy.
Out there, Western Suburbs, wearing gloves because it's a little bit cold. Come on, Duke.
Yeah, they always knew there was something different about him.
There is. Well, we know he's got a skinny head.
Sleeps
fit in
his,
a coin slot,
sleeps
I reckon.
With his head in a vice chief's head.
That's right.
which was hard to argue,
wasn't it?
When you have a look at the bonce on the Duke, it is hard to argue.
Especially when he gets
that
little mud flap.
To me the side.
When he gets the long head, a little mud flap out the back, because he's got the skinny head, it sort of gets a little bit of wing, a little fuel scoop out the back of each head.
One of those bike helmets.
Yeah, that's the mud flap, and it's like a little reverse fuel scoop. Spoiler on a car, that's what it is.
Do you reckon when he opened up the bag, obviously, from the wardrobe department at 7, do you reckon he saw it coming?
No, this is the point.
What did he
say? I didn't get a chance to talk to him last night about it because I like to take him aside and have a quiet word in his ear.
Well, I think you need to.
I will. But, I mean, that is what I wanted to ask him. At what stage, when you got yourself settled on your desk, out on the ground and you're looking around, you go, oh, it's a bit chilly, and then you go and you pull out the skin-tight leatheries and think, if I put these on, I wonder whether this will come back to haunt me maybe at some stage. And he must have gone, no, this will be a good look. So I'll put them on.
And the thing, well, Gary, I couldn't agree with you anymore. And the thing is, correct me if I'm wrong, Hose, he's had Mick go through him nice and early.
Yeah.
So Mick Malloy giving him a real short back and sides. Then he's copped it from the rush hour when he rang in to try and claim something to do with Melbourne Public. So he copped a good 5 minutes there.
And the Duck gave it to him on his own show on Monday night.
The Duck's given it to him Monday night. Then he copped it last night. So you reckon he went to bed last night thinking, well, hey, that's Christ, the end of that.
I reckon his beautiful wife, Beck, might just pull him aside and say, listen,
someone needs to.
You are fast becoming a tool.
That's it.
I think he is a tool.
He's got kids now who are old enough to be able to say, Dad,
that's
you're embarrassing
it. That's
me.
It.
I've got to go to school and cop
it.
This. And so all those things need to be. And wife important and kids, but we probably more important than anyone, being dragged along with him.
We're all on notice. That's the thing that I'm disappointed in.